Are you looking to join a network marketing or start a network marketing business or MLM? This is the video for you because I'm going to show you the five truths about network marketing. Hi there, Gordon Attard here. Welcome to this video. And in this video, we're going to talk about some truths, because this video came up because of a lot of people on YouTube sharing their thoughts about the industry. Some of them are not qualified to talk about the industry or the profession because they've never done it. They've never done it in a higher level, or they just heard about it and they shoot a video and that's it. So in this video, we're going to talk about the five truths about or of network marketing, and a great video or a great channel to follow. Make sure you go and check out Tim Sales. He's doing some amazing things on his YouTube channel. I will link it in the description below. If you're here for the very first time, welcome. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the notification bell for more videos like this, okay? And click the thumbs up button and leave a comment if you have maybe any question, or if you agree or disagree with me, it doesn't matter, but it matters for me and to communicate and engage with you as well. So let's get started. Enough chat, and let's start with the first one. So again, I really wanted to do these videos because a lot of people, they just get into the industry or get into the profession, they are new, and as they are starting to share the products or opportunity with their family members and cousins and friends, they tell them, okay, so number one is network marketing is easy. No, it's not. So network marketing is not easy. It's like any other business that you've got to say the right things, because otherwise people, this is why people are damaging the profession, because of what they say. And when you go with that attitude, when you go with saying that network marketing is easy, or you're telling, okay, if you did that mistake, let me know in the comments below, that you're telling someone that network marketing is easy, okay, that you're gonna do a lot of money and you're gonna get this house or this car, etc., etc. There's nothing wrong about dreaming, but don't say that network marketing is easy, because it's not. That's the truth. Okay, that's the number one truth from this video. So network marketing is simple in a way that there are systems. If you follow the system, you're gonna have success. If you're trying to change the weed, 99.9%, you're not gonna have success. And a lot of people fail is because they quit early, they don't have the right mentorship, and the third one is because they try to reinvent the wheel every 3 to 6 or 9 months. So very important, it's not easy. I saw a lot of people who quit early, who didn't have the right mentorship, and or they never followed what their mentor is telling them. So that's another type of people. And also the third type of people are who just continuously reinvent the wheel. So it's not easy, it's doable, but there's a simple success proven system if you follow it. And again, this is very, very important. A lot of people on social media or on YouTube, they bash the industry because they have seen posts, they have seen maybe other videos that they say that the industry or the business to build it, it's easy. It's not, okay? But there are ways to do it just like any other kind of business. So if you are doing this, or if you did it in the past, stop doing it, because you're not doing great or good for you and for your business, neither it is for the profession out there, okay? So that's number one truth, that network marketing is easy, it's not. So let's move to number two. So number two, the second truth that I'm gonna share with you in this video is that it is a low barrier entry. So anyone can afford to get in because you don't pay those crazy costs like a conventional business. So under $500 you get in to a business, you can start your own, you have your starter kit, whatever it is, the company that you decide to join. Yes, okay, that's yes, it's a truth, there's a low barrier entry, but a lot of people get into this mindset, kind of mindset, That's because it's a low barrier entry. A lot of people in the profession, they join and they quit. They join and they quit. So although it's a low barrier entry, understand, have that mindset that you need to invest in your business. You need to go to events. You need to get your skills up. As I always say in these videos, you've got to invest in yourself. A lot of people, just like myself, when I got started, I never had a business experience, never studied marketing, never had any sales jobs, whatever it is. I was a chef. So to make that transition from the mindset of an employee, a lot of people are doing network marketing or do network marketing on the side. So it's a sidekick. They just dedicate a few hours a week, maybe 4 or 6 hours a week before they do the transition. But the transition starts in here. So it's hard to transition, but it's doable from an employee mindset to an entrepreneur or business mindset. And this is when you've got to invest in you. Although it's a low, yes, it's a low barrier entry, under $500, as I said, you can get in. You've got to invest in you. A lot of people, your past, unfortunately, your past can influence your present and your present future. What do I mean by that, Gordon? So, Gordon, what do you mean by that? Because it's whatever you did in the past, okay? In this profession, whatever it is that you studied, your skills, especially your skills, what skills do you have? If you worked in a sales job prior, okay, you have potentially are gonna do well in network marketing. If you did real estate, for example. So those are skills that you learned on the job, or you learned because you attended the real estate course, whatever it is the case, that you're gonna use in your business. But if you were like me, I started not from zero, but below zero. I had no skills that to help me to grow my network marketing business. You have to start from something, and investing in yourself is the number one key to start learning those skills. A lot of people, they get in, they just spend $200, $500, and they think they're gonna be successful by not going to events, by not investing in themselves, etc., etc. You've got, okay, this is the single truth. Number two, the truth is you've got to continuously invest in yourself. So any top income earner, maybe that in a company that you're looking into, maybe you're already in a company, you know that they are always at events, they are always investing in themselves. You see them flying to different countries, sometimes even international, to keep learning, to network with people, because again, it's network. So you've got to network to increase your net worth. And also it's marketing. So you've got to learn how to market, especially yourself, because people are gonna join you, whatever it is the company you're gonna do. And that's another thing that is very, very important. Learning how to market yourself, learning what kind of content you can put out to attract the right people to join your business. And we're gonna talk more about this in the last step and the fifth truth in this video. So let's move on to number three. So number three is that company events are important. Yes, company events are important, but it's not all. Why? Why I'm saying this, why I'm claiming this? Because I saw a lot of people, also had people in my team that they were committed to the events. They went every single event that the company puts up. Sometimes, or most of the times, are abroad. So imagine if they have to invest for the ticket, they have to invest for the flight, accommodation, and the food, etc., etc. You know how it goes when you go abroad to an event. So it doesn't mean that because they are there always, you're gonna be successful. And this is my point here, this is my truth here, is that going to events, it's good. Getting your team to events is even better. Actually, it's the best way to go, but it's not enough. Okay, it's not enough. You're not gonna be successful by going to events. You're gonna be successful by applying certain principles. Sometimes it is one nugget, two nuggets, or three nuggets to your business. Maybe a strategy that you've learned, or maybe a speaker shared a strategy. Implementing this immediately and taking action upon it, that's where it can change your path to paving way to your success. So company events, I highly recommend you to go. Yes, it's very, very important to go, but it's not enough. Okay, some people misinterpret this, that they go to events. I see them every event, you know, and they do not do any action, or they do not apply any of those strategies shared. Perhaps you learned a strategy also on how to use social media, or whatever it is, or a funnel, whatever it is, and you didn't apply. because something is holding you back, because you think that you need to be a tech savvy. All you need to do is follow a system. Okay, follow a system, follow your mentor system if they have, follow the company system if it's in place. But again, okay, do not just rely on company going to company events, because going and doing nothing is what's gonna hurt you. You're gonna hurt your pockets, and it's gonna hurt you by being demotivated. At the end of the day, that's what happens. You go, you go to an event, you are motivated, you come back, you don't put any action, and after 3 weeks, after a few weeks, you're gonna be demotivated again. And it's like you're looking to the next event to be motivated again. Motivation wears off. You get to be every single day motivated. So I don't know what you do to get motivated, but I'm sure that maybe a song gets you motivated. What is your favorite song? Listen to it. If it motivates you, then why don't you listen to it? Listen to it every single day. Okay, that makes you motivated. So, or maybe something else, maybe a video on YouTube, whatever it is that gets you motivated, listen to it every single day. That's how, okay, you trick your mind to be constantly motivated. Because events are not, don't just use events for motivation, use them as inspiration from the stories that you've learned and the strategies that you've learned, apply them so you can pave your way to success. So that's the third truth. Attending company events are important. Let's move on to number four. So number four is anyone can do it. Anyone can do it if they have the desire, they have huge ambition, okay, and they are coachable, teachable, and trainable. Not anyone can do it in a sense that they get in because they heard anyone can do it. It's like a claim, no? Anyone can do it. If they have desire, they are driven, they are willing to put in the work, they are coachable, teachable, and trainable. Otherwise, they cannot do it. That's the truth. They cannot do it. You know, again, tons of people, I talk with a lot of people every single time, and I had people that they had a glimpse. They had potential, like everybody. I believe that everybody has potential to do great, not just in network marketing, but in any kind of business that they venture in. But there's a but. A lot of people, they start to be excited. They're excited, right? They're excited, they're motivated, they're like looking forward to do great things, which is great. Okay, enthusiasm breeds influence, enthusiasm breeds leadership, enthusiasm move mountains and create momentum. So after that, they might hurt something. They might stumble on an objection, stumble on rejection every single time, which happens. I mean, in any kind of business, not just in network marketing, you're gonna have rejection. And rejection is something that humans, we are afraid of. We tend to be like scared when someone tells us no, okay? Think about when you went out or when you were even younger, you started dating and the girl of your dreams said no, you get disappointed, same thing here. And it's because they think that no, they are saying no to them. No, they're not saying no to you, no to the opportunity at that moment on time. So again, what we have developed in the last few weeks is to have a system as well, not just relying on the offline, how to create an auto-recruiting funnel system that will filter out this kind of rejection, and you talk with the right people. Okay, there's still the human touch. Obviously, you need to connect with them, you need to call them up and things like that. To know more, this is in the description below, there will be more information about that. Why we did this is because we want to go through the numbers. You see, anyone who is driven, anyone who is focused, they don't care about a no, they don't care about what others are saying about the profession, because they have lack of information and lack of knowledge. They just go through the numbers, and this will help you go through the numbers even faster, because it's designed for that as well. And if not, if you're building offline, you can still do it, okay, offline, but you have to go through the rejection, the face-to-face rejection, etc., etc., which most people, if you're an introvert, it's gonna be demotivating. Okay, it's gonna be demotivating. And a lot, anyone can do it. To continue on that, is there's two kinds of people. There are introverts and non-introverts. Okay, so introverts are gonna find it hard in the beginning, especially in the beginning when you start building offline and things like that. But those extroverts, okay, the extroverts are gonna have that aura, are gonna attract those people because they are extrovert. But there's a highly chance that one is introvert. So there's introverts in the world and extroverts. I don't know you, let me know in the comments below if you're an extrovert or an introvert. But again, you have to assume that you're gonna have people who are introverts. So certain strategies, you know, going out and talk with someone in a restaurant or in a mall, an introvert, they're not gonna do that. Okay, they're not gonna do that. So they cannot build a network marketing business using Gordon? No, I'm not saying that. There's ways and means how nowadays using technology and social media that change the industry, you can do it as well. Now, moving on, so that's another truth, the fourth truth, anyone can do it. Not anyone can do it, okay? Again, it's if they're driven, ambitious, they're willing to put in the work, and they're teachable, coachable, and trainable. So the fifth truth is that you only need a couple of people or three people to make big things in the profession. There's some truth in that. If you're past, if you have been in business, maybe you know an entrepreneur, or maybe you have been in contact with a network marketing professional, they have big teams, you can be lucky. That's why I always say that your past determines somehow your success in network marketing, if you have those kind of contacts, right? But most people, I'm in favor of most people out there, they have never done network marketing before, because a lot of new people are joining the profession because they're seeing the potential, and a lot of people have limited contacts, okay? If you were like me, I have limited contacts. I live in a small village, like close to 3,000 people living here. I never went to networking events prior to joining the profession, never had, didn't know how to use systems like technology, etc., etc. So it's all big learning curve for me. And this is why with the online recruiting system that we have designed, we are helping a lot of people go through that learning curve, even compressing that in a major way, and they can scale it to the next level as much as they want. So not everyone is gonna find those three people that you need. And you cannot stop with three people, because people are designed to venture into new things most of the time. So if those quit, or one of them quit, your income will take a hit. Okay, will take a hit. So you've got to be constantly looking for new people, looking for new blood, and that is the priority. Okay, without a list, without people to talk to, you don't have business. So you've got to focus on that. How I'm gonna get in front my opportunity, my products in front of new people. So you've got to go through the numbers to find those three people or four people, but I highly suggest you to don't stop if you just find three people. Keep building, keep developing leadership, and that they follow the system, that then they are learning the system, they are teaching the system, and they are leaders in your team. Without you being there, they're still growing and they're still going to the next level. So those are the five truths about or of network marketing. If you found this video helpful, click the thumbs up button, leave a comment down below, and let me know about what you thought about this video. And if you want to add something, comment something else that you have learned, or maybe you expected to be listed in this video or said in this video, leave it in the comments down below. So again, if you haven't subscribed yet to my YouTube channel, please do. And that's all I have for this video. Thanks for watching once again, my friends, and I'll see you on the next video. Take care, bye-bye.